apartment forever.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the first episode of Jane and Kara Endless Quality. Now, it's unfortunate that we had to start at the, you know, season finales, but, you know, it's well worth it. And the reason why I haven't been reviewing the episodes lately is because I wanted to save them all for this particular video, where I can put them all together in this brand new series. So I'm just very emotional right now because I had to say goodbye to two of my favorite characters of all time. And it's not an easy thing to do. Like, yes, I know they're coming back, but it's just hard to say goodbye, you know. So anyway, Let's start with Supergirl. So, the whole entire season of Supergirl was really good. It had some great character moments. The best character arc in the entire series was Alex's, because it made, you know, it brought, like, the character that has gotten the most development in this season has been Alex, because she's went through the transformation of being gay and having this relationship with Maggie. And we see at the end of this episode that she asked Maggie to marry her. And to me, I was really happy when she said that, because, you know, she's went through so much development to the point where you feel like she really, like, both of them really deserve it, you know. And what happens during the fight between Kara and Superman, Kara definitely wins. I mean, obviously it's her show, but, you know, I had full faith in her. I knew she was going to win, but, you know, it was a cool fight, too. And, you know, at the end of, like, in the climax of this episode, they put, like, they basically have this device that Lex Luthor created to where they can put a whole bunch of lead into the atmosphere, and it will poison all Daxamites to make so they can leave forever. And, you know, there's only one problem. You know, Mon-El is a Daxamite, so I really enjoyed this because it gave us an emotional scene with Kara having to say goodbye to Mon-El. And, you know, it was sad, you know. And, you know, this tonight had a lot to do with goodbyes, you know what I mean? But, yeah. And Mon-El goes in the same pod that Kara went in as back in season one during the pilot. And before he goes in there, Kara gives him the necklace that her mother gave her before she left. And then, you know, he leaves, and when we see him going, notice that he goes into, like, this portal, and we don't really know what it is, but how the episode, you know, kind of ends, we know. And we kind of get the hint that, you know, she's basically going to, you know, try to find out where he is. And the second ending to this episode was interesting because it goes all the way back to when they left Krypton. And, you know, when it shows them, Kara and Cal, you know, going, it zooms into this other castle, and it shows these hooded figures putting this baby into a pod and saying, you know, it will destroy everything. And Could this be Superboy? Because I had a theory when season two first started that Mon-El was Superboy, but I was wrong. So could this be Superboy? Probably, but I'm not sure. I guess we'll find out when season three comes in because both Jane the Virgin and Supergirl have been renewed, so that's good. But yeah, this season was really good, and it was definitely a great finish to an amazing season. So, going over now to Jane the Virgin, like, I've already said how perfect this show is. Like, seriously, at this point, I'm at a loss for words to how perfect this show is. I mean, it's always been quality, and this last episode was the maximum achievement of quality. I give both of these shows a quality award. Hey, I had to give them their own show. That's how good these two are. So, yeah, in this episode, sorry, I'm still sick right now. Part being sick and emotional. Rogelio and Xiomara are getting married, and everything's going wrong. There's a hurricane going on. The power goes out at one point. Xiomara's wedding dress gets ruined, and all these different things are happening, but one key element is that Raphael's sister and Petra's twin sister, Ernesca, they get in a car together and they basically become like the new evil duo, whatever you want to call it. And they basically put them both in this situation where, one where Ernesca's pointing a gun at Petra and she's going to shoot her. And, Raphael's sister basically has this, she has the deed to the Marbella. And she basically tells him, "Look, I own this place now. Get out." And so he leaves, and we'll see how that goes in the fourth season. And so the revelation that Jane goes through is that she, throughout the entire episode, she's looking for this letter that Michael wrote her in case of, hard times. And so she finds this letter, and she's reading it, and all of a sudden, like this surprised me. Like, I knew he was going to be in it, but I guess I forgot. So I was taken by complete surprise. So out of nowhere, I don't know, Tyler Posey shows up out of nowhere. And if you don't know who Tyler Posey is, you may know him from Teen Wolf. That's right, Teen Wolf. Oh man, I was freaking out when I saw him, 'cause I love Teen Wolf. And I think that's a great show, and I think he's one of the best parts of that show. And the fact that he's going to be on Jane the Virgin now is absolutely incredible. Because Teen Wolf recently came to an end, and that's sad. So, the fact that he's going to be on this show now is really good, and I can't wait to see what he can offer to the show. And so, I give this episode and the entire third season a 10 out of 10. I will give both of these seasons a combined 20 out of 20. So, we have reached that point. The point where I have to say goodbye. And it's very hard, you know? Like, I love these shows, and it's hard to see them go, you know? I know you're probably listening to me and you think I'm crazy, but really, these shows are part of the reason why I am so excited for the week. Because really I have, because I hate Mondays. Mondays are like the worst days of the week, in my opinion. But with Jane and Kara, it's like they make that day for me, you know? Like, they absolutely make that day for me. And they're the reason why I love Mondays. And so, the fact that they're going to be gone for a long amount of time, I just can't deal with it. I can't. And with everything that's happened in these shows and development that's happened, I just want them to stay, but I know that they have to leave. So before they go, I just want to give them a tribute video because I love these two with all my heart, with all my soul, with everything that I am, everything that I have. I love these shows. I will love these shows till my dying breath. And they will always be in my history books as I'm